you can now create calculated metrics in GA4 Google Analytics 4. I'm going to show you how to create them, I'll talk about some important limitations you'll need to be aware of, and I'll also show you a weird bug you might encounter when creating your own calculated metric. So stick around as we explore the new calculated metrics in Google Analytics. Calculated metrics let you combine existing metrics to create new ones that you can use in your reports. For example, if you're tracking a banner on your website as a promotion, you could calculate the average number of views that result in conversions. Or maybe you want to create a calculated metric to report on estimated profit. You can use calculated metrics to do this. We're going to start by covering the steps to create a calculated metric, and I'll also share some limitations you might encounter. Okay, let's head to Google Analytics. To create calculated metrics, we need to navigate to Admin. Now we select Custom Definitions in the Property column. Then we choose the Calculated Metrics tab. This is where we can see any existing calculated metrics and create new ones. To create calculated metrics, you will need administrator or editor permission for the property. If you don't have administrator or editor permission, you won't be able to create calculated metrics. Since I have the correct level of permission for this property, let's click Create Calculated Metric. Now we need to name our calculated metric, add an optional description, enter the formula, and select the unit of measurement. Let's start by naming our first calculated metric, inactive users. We're going to create this metric so we can report on the number of users who aren't active. Google Analytics focuses on active users, which include users who are considered engaged and users who are visiting the website for the first time. So we can create a calculated metric that subtracts the number of active users from the total number of users on our website. To learn more about these terms, I've included a link to my Google Analytics glossary in the description below this video. Now let's add a short description for our calculated metric. And for the formula, we can now choose from the metrics that are automatically available in Google Analytics and any custom metrics we've created. For this calculated metric, let's enter total users and select the default metric. Now let's enter a dash for minus and let's enter active users and select the default metric. This will mean our calculated metric is the total number of users minus the number of active users on our website. Let's leave standard as the unit of measurement. And let's save our calculated metric. Before we look at the reports, let's create another calculated metric. Let's click Create Calculated Metric again. Let's name the metric Estimated Profit. Let's enter a description. And we're going to use a simple calculation for this metric. Let's select the total revenue metric, and let's multiply this by 0.2. This should give us an estimated profit based on 20% of our overall revenue. Let's select currency as the unit of measurement, and let's save the metric. We've now created two custom metrics we can use in our reports. What calculated metrics are you going to create? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments. And for more ideas of calculated metrics you might want to create, check out the link in the description below this video. Okay, before we look at how we can use calculated metrics in our reports, I want to talk about limitations you might hit with calculated metrics. First up, Google is currently limiting the combinations you can use when creating calculated metrics. Let's create another calculated metric to see this. And let's try creating a metric that combines, say, conversions or transactions with the total number of users. We can see this isn't currently possible. Let's close this. I find this a bit frustrating because this is something we could do in Universal Analytics, which was the previous version of Google Analytics. Hopefully this changes soon in the new version. Next is we can only create a total of 5 calculated metrics in the standard version of Google Analytics. This means you need to prioritize which metrics you create because you'll hit that limit really quickly. Other limitations are that we can't control the number of decimal places. All the calculated metrics I've created so far appear to be rounded up to a whole number, and selecting the unit of measurement doesn't appear to have any impact. For example, you would expect that selecting the currency would add a dollar sign or similar before the metric, but it doesn't. Now let's look at how we can use calculated metrics in our reports. Let's navigate to Reports. The first way you can use the calculated metrics you've created is by adding them to the standard reports. Again, you will need editor or administrator access to do this. Let's select Acquisition and open the Traffic Acquisition Report. Now let's click the pencil icon on the top right corner of the report. We can now select Metrics, then Add Metric, and choose one of the calculated metrics we created. This lets you add your very own metrics to the standard reports. Now let's head back. And let's navigate to Explore. Let's create a new blank report. Let's name the report Calculated Metrics. Now let's click the plus sign next to Metrics. And under Custom, we can find our calculated metrics, plus any custom metrics we've created. Let's enable our estimated profit and inactive users metrics. And let's also search for and enable the default total revenue metric. The total users metric. And the active users metric. Now let's click Import. And let's add the metrics to our report. We can see that our inactive users metric is correct. So we can now report on the number of users who aren't considered active in Google Analytics. But our estimated profit metric doesn't look right. This is because there is a strange bug that pops up when using some metrics in our calculation. Until Google fixes this issue, we will need to adjust things. So let's navigate back to Admin. Select Custom Definitions. Then Calculated Metrics, and let's edit our estimated profit metric. To fix this metric up, we need to put total revenue inside brackets, divide revenue by 10 million, and then multiply the total by 3. Now we can save our metric. This shouldn't happen, but if you encounter this issue, now you know how to fix it. Now let's navigate back to our exploration report and open it. We can now see our estimated profit metric is correct. Since there are some limitations to calculated metrics, you can also use Looker Studio. If you'd like to learn more about creating metrics in Looker Studio, check out my dedicated tutorial. It covers the steps to create additional metrics, and if you haven't already, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel to learn even more ways you can use Google Analytics. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.